Hello dear students and all the listeners. Today we are going to study about chapter number 2, Computer Systems. This is the part 2 of the chapter which will talk about the output devices. Please refer to the previous video for input devices if you haven't. Now let's explore the types of output devices. First of all, let us understand what is an output device. The processed results or information given by the computer system is called an output. Any hardware equipment that gives output is generated by the computer is called an output device. The most common output devices are monitors, printers, and speakers. A monitor, usually referred as VDU, that means a visual display unit, gives output as well as the visual display. A speaker gives out sound, and the printer produces the hard copy of a paper. Now let's explore all the output devices. The first and the main device is the visual display unit, that means VDU. It is also called a monitor or a screen, which gives us the output as a visual display. Physically, it looks similar to a television screen and displays both images and text. The output displayed on the monitor is called soft copy because images displayed on the screen are temporary and do not last forever. They are available in both multicolor and black and white, that means monochrome. A VDU is made up of small blocks of colored light called pixels. The resolution of the screen is the number of pixels there are up, down, and front and left and across the screen. The more number of pixels, the better the resolution of the screen and the clarity of the output. The standard VDU was originally a text-only mode, but slowly the resolution of VDUs was increased to support the graphics mode. As you can see on the screen, the CRT monitor was the first one to come. Then we had LCD, then LED, and now we are having the touchscreen devices. The monitors can be classified into the following categories. Let us see the CRT monitors first. CRT stands for cathode ray tube. These are all old model monitors. The main disadvantage of a CRT is that it is heavyweight, occupies more space, consumes high power, has high radiation and supports very low resolution. Then we have the LCD monitors. LCD stands for liquid crystal display. The main advantage of LCDs are they are very lightweight, they occupy less space and consumes less power. They emit less radiation and supports high resolution. Then we have the LED monitors. LED stands for light emitting diode. There are no differences between LCD and LED monitors, but due to the better picture quality, LED monitors are preferred over LCD monitors. Then we have the touchscreen. A touchscreen is a display screen that allows the user to interact with the computer by just touching at the pictures or words with a special stylus or finger. A touchscreen is only a device which works as an input as well as an output device. Touchscreens have become very common on tablets, smartphones, and other mobile devices also. Let us see our next output device, that is the printer. A printer is an output device that prints out information in the computer to a paper. These output on paper is known as the hard copy. Printers are classified into two different types based on their speed and print quality. The two main types of printers are impact and non-impact printers. The impact printers use a print head containing of number of metal pins which strike on inked ribbon placed between the print head and the paper. Due to this mechanic contact between the components, there is a lot of noise while printing. Such printers have lower speed of printing. Impact printers are divided into two further categories, the line printer and the serial printer. The line printer print one line of text at a time. The printing speed lies in the range of 300 to 3000 lines per minute. These are generally used when there is a heavy load of printing to be done. The serial printer print one character at a time. These are slower printers with printing speed that lies in the range of 30 to 600 characters per second. The line printer is furthermore divided into two categories, the drum printer and the chain printer. Let us see the chain printer. In the chain printers, the characters are positioned in a line on a print chain. The chain or band is rotated at high speed. A magnetically driven hammer strikes the character when it comes to its position and is printed. The number of hammers will be equal to the number of characters per line. This can print up to 132 characters per line. The speed lies in the range of 400 to 2400 lines per minute and have high noise levels. In drum printers, the characters are embossed on a rotating cylindrical drum. Each line consists of a complete set of characters. The drum rotates at high speed and a magnetically driven hammer strikes the character. The hammer strikes the ribbon and the paper against the character on the drum when it comes to the correct position. It is very noisy. The speed of printing lies in the range of 200 to 2000 lines per minute. These printers are very expensive. The serial printers are also divided into two categories, namely dot matrix printers and daisy wheel printers. Let us see the dot matrix printer. The dot matrix printers are the most commonly used serial printers. As the name suggests, the characters are formed to a matrix of dots. The print head consists of an array of pins in the form of a matrix. The print head moves horizontally across the paper. The correct pins fire according to the character or the pattern to be formed. Some have 9 pins and the better ones have 24 pins. They print each line and automatically move to the next line. The dot matrix printer can be unidirectional or bidirectional. The speed is usually 30 to 550 characters per second. This is the cheapest and the noisiest printer of the family. The standard of print obtained is very poor. These printers are cheap to run and relatively fast. They are useful for low quality carbon copy printing, that means the Xerox. Coming to the daisy wheel printers, daisy wheel printer is a type of letter quality printer. These printers print entire character at a time rather than dots. The print head is shaped like a daisy flower with print arms that look like the petals of the flowers. Metal or plastic characters like those in a typewriter are found on the tip of each print arm on a raised mount, as you can see on the image. This wheel is mounted on a rotating wheel. As the wheel rotates, the characters are printed on the paper by means of a hammer that strike on the print ribbon. This results in a great deal of movement and noise during the printing, making the printing very slow, that is less than 90 characters per second. The standard of print is similar to that of an electric typewriter. As the characters on the wheel are fixed, the size and the font can only be changed by changing the whole wheel itself, which is very rarely done. All the previously seen printers were the impact printer types. Now we are going to see the non-impact printers. In non-impact printers, there is no physical contact between the printing heads and the printing surface, so the printing is much quieter and almost noiseless. Such printers are very fast with an ability to print a lot of pages per minute. Different technologies like laser, inkjet, thermal, chemical, electrostatic, etc. exist, giving a wide range of printers. There are mainly three types of non-impact printers: the thermal printer, inkjet printer and laser printer. Now let us talk about the thermal printer. If you see the image of thermal printer on the screen, you will easily identify this as you have already seen this in your day-to-day life. In a thermal printer, the characters are formed when heated elements come in contact with a special heat-sensitive paper. They form darkened dots when the elements reach a critical temperature. Each character is formed by a series of dots. The printhead consists of heating elements. The thermal printer paper tends to darken over the time due to exposure to sunlight and heat. The print quality produced is poor as compared to other non-impact printers. The speed of this printer is less than 200 characters per second. Thermal printers are widely used in battery-powered equipment such as portable calculators, fax machine, and credit card machines. Now coming to the inkjet printers, here the characters are formed by fine jets of ink drops. The ink drops are electrically charged or heated and are sprayed into the fine jets on the paper using a nozzle. The nozzle in the printing head produces high resolution dot matrix characters to the quality of up to 400 dots per inch. Inkjet printers use color cartridges which combines magenta, yellow and cyan inks to create color tones. A black cartridge is also used for the crisp monochrome output. These cartridges are very expensive. This method of printing can generate up to 200 characters per second and allows for good quality, cheap color printing. Photographs can be printed by using special glossy paper. These printers are available in wide range of prices and models. Now let's see the laser printer. They are the non-impact printers that use a laser beam technology and dry powdered ink for printing. It consists of photoconductive drum that is completely charged initially. Then a high intensity laser beam is used to discharge the selected areas on the drum. Toner in the form of fine powder is attracted to parts of the drum with charged areas. The drum rotates and transfers the toner to the paper, which has a higher electrical charge. Finally, a heater fixes the toner onto the paper. A laser printer has good printing speed and can generate a minimum of 4 pages of A4 size page per minute. The printing quality is very good and hence produced very good quality graphics too. These printers used to be expensive, but today they are easily available. Now let us discuss about the plotters. As in the printer, we have limited page size. If we want to take large size printing, therefore the printer is not suitable. Thus, we have the plotters. Plotters are special output devices that produce output on a paper or polyester films. Plotters are used to produce high quality graphs, charts, diagrams or visuals. They can produce single or multicolored outputs. They are used for specialized drawings with application like CAD, that is the computer-aided design, which require high quality precision graphics. A plotter can be connected to the port normally used by a printer. The plotters can be classified into the following types: the flatbed plotter, drum plotter, electrostatic plotter and inkjet plotter. Let us see how they work. Let us first see the flatbed plotter. This is a plotter where the paper is fixed on a flat surface and pens are moved to draw the image. This plotter can use several different color pens to draw with. The size of the plot is limited only by the size of plotter's bed. The drum plotter also uses pen for drawing and are much bigger than the flatbed plotters. The pen is moved horizontally in a single axis track. The paper itself moves on a cylindrical drum in the clockwise or anti-clockwise direction, perpendicular to that of the paper. Both the pens and the paper are moving under the instructions from the computer. Several multicolored pens are kept in the pen carriage, which helps in creating multicolored diagram. Drum plotters also have extremely accurate paper feed mechanisms. The size of the graph is therefore limited only by the width of the drum and can be of any length. So these plotters are usually used by architects, surveyors, engineers and pattern markers. Coming over to the electrostatic plotters. Electrostatic plotters work similar to a laser printer. It produces an image by charging the paper with high voltage. This voltage attracts the toner, which is then melted into the paper with heat. This type of plotter is fast, but the quality is generally considered to be poor when compared to the pen plotters. Next is the inkjet plotters. Inkjet plotters use ink instead of the ink pen and work similar to the drum plotter. Now let us see one more output device known as the speakers. Speakers are the output devices that gives the sound as an output. They have a low power internal amplifier. The computer speakers designed to be connected to the computer system are small plastic boxes with mediocre sound quality. Some computer systems have inbuilt speakers, but these do not have good sound quality. Laptops also come with internal speakers due to the restricted space. This means that these speakers produce low quality sound and the sound quality is not as good as that of the external speakers. Nowadays, there is a wide range of speakers available due to the extensive increase in the media consumption. Sophisticated computer speakers have a buffer unit also to enhance the quality of the bass output. Let us learn about robots and machine tools. Robots are able to perform a variety of tasks by executing instructions supplied in the form of pre-recorded program. You see a lot of robots and androids in science fiction films, but we have a long way to go to reach to that level of technology. Robots are used in automated machines designed to perform mundane and boring operations which require accuracy, such as assembling cars. They are also used in places like metallurgy, where extreme conditions of temperature and pressure exist. We use robotic arms to carry out dangerous work, such as dealing with hazardous material or carrying out tasks in outer space, where humans cannot survive. Robotic arms are also used in the field of medicine, such as conducting experiments without exposing the researcher to various radiations or microbes. Machine tools are used in manufacturing units and factories. These have a clear advantages over human in terms of high accuracy and diligence. They can work for long hours accurately without even a coffee break. So here we come to an end of the chapter 2. I hope you have understood all the concepts clearly. Below enlisted are some activities that you can do to clear your concepts. Thank you. Good luck.